A key component of the modern world economy, the chemical industry delivers products and innovations to enhance everyday life. It is also an industry in transformation, where chemical executives and workers are delivering growth and industry-changing advancements while responding to pressures from investors, regulators, and public opinion. Discover how leading companies are approaching these challenges here on The Chemical Show. Join Victoria Meyer, president of Progressio Global and host of The Chemical Show, as she speaks with executives across the industry and learns how they are leading their companies to grow, transform, and push industry boundaries on all frontiers. Here's your host, Victoria Meyer.
Hi, this is Victoria Meyer. Welcome back to The Chemical Show. This is a Thursday quick hitter episode, which is a bit more tactical in nature. On these Thursday episodes, I'm addressing topics and questions that I'm hearing from folks in the industry, some relevant news and timely happenings that we're seeing, and then giving strategic and tactical answers and approaches. The topic of this episode is being resilient during market softness. So there's a few things that prompted this topic. One, a business leader told me recently, our business is down pretty significantly this year. So I'm helping my team do different things this year so that we understand our value and that we're gaining business successfully. Number two, one of the other things that prompted this episode is on episode 102 with John Richardson, we discussed the structural demand slowdown in China, which frankly has global ramifications, as we know, given the impact and the importance of China in the global chemical industry. And thirdly, I am continuing to hear from clients, you hear it in earnings calls and when you read the news reports, demand softness continues in this first half of 2023, largely due to inventory buildup in the supply chain, which still needs to be worked through. There's also some inflationary pressures, no doubt, as we're seeing significant inflation across all regions. And then the other thing I think we're seeing that affects this is a shift towards services from products, right? So anyone that's traveled recently knows that airplanes are full. It is busy. Everybody wants to get out and about doing things, not just buying stuff. And so that has a significant effect on net demand across the industry, at least in the near term, right? So I would say it's not necessarily structural changes, although there could be some. But it's also not necessarily a widespread economic slowdown, right? As I record this episode, we've got reports of the S&P 500 moving back into bull territory, right? Cruising, I guess is what I would say. I've talked to somebody, you know, just today again recently that said, you know, we're in growth mode. We've got a new business and new products. So we're not comparing it to what we used to be. We're focused on growth and markets. So we're certainly seeing a wide range of economic conditions depending on geography, depending on the specific markets and end uses for products and services. But no doubt, there is a market softness on an overall basis. And what I find to be really critical to resilience in these times of market softness is getting back to basics. So as a former boss of mine was fond of saying, a rising tide raises all ships. But when the tide is out, as it is today, that's when foundations are built. And I think we can all agree that there were some great results and a lot of momentum and changes across the industry in the past 2 years. But now is the time for resilience and getting back to basics. So let's talk about that. First of all, number one, identify your unique value. This is back to basics 101. Understand the value that your company, your products and services are bringing to the table and sell it. Right. So a materials company told me recently that they had done some work around this, that they said, you know what, it's a little bit harder to go out and market and position and sell our products. And so we have to do that. They did the work to basically go in and show a customer how their product performed and lasted twice as long as the competition and delivered double the results. work that maybe that they would not have done a year or two ago, even though it was good work to be done, but they were busy. They were busy. They were full. But they said, oh, we need to go do some extra work. So they went back, they understood the value, and they really talked value and value in use to their customer. Result was, you know, they expanded their orders from 2 sites to 8 sites without lowering price. In fact, price, as I've said before, price is a bit of a red herring, right? It is an easy thing to say, oh, you didn't win the business because of price, but there is always something else. One of the things that came out recently from Grace Matthews, an M&A firm, in their recent newsletter, which I'll attach in the show notes, is that as they've studied businesses, earnings reports, businesses that they know and that they've studied, and one of the things they've said is while volumes are down, companies seem to have had more success in maintaining price increases than in prior years, given their increased stickiness of their customer base. So, you know, what leads to stickiness, great customer experience and a lot of other things, a reshuffling of global supply chains and higher service levels. So getting to value, getting back to basics, understanding your value, driving value and demonstrating it creates opportunity and creates growth, especially in times of market softness. You can't assume that people know what the value is that your company, that your product, that your services bring to the table. You have to identify it, articulate it, and share it. So that's one. The second piece is diversification of customers and markets. I almost tie this back to classic market segmentation, right? Do you know who your potential customers are, what's important to them, and how they work with you? Have you identified those new opportunities? Have you segmented your markets, right? In the past several years, many people thought they've done that. And heck, maybe given the softness of second half 2022, you did, right? You did some of this work. But here we are, first half, almost into the second half of 2023, market is still a bit soft, softer than we'd like it to be, and it's time to revisit it. This is, you know, basic marketing and business management 101, understanding your markets, segmenting your markets, understanding your customers. And really, you need to be doing this at least twice a year and in times of market softness, quarterly, revisiting it, going out and getting that information and bringing it back into your models, bringing it back into your segmentation, bringing it back into your understanding of your customers and markets. That's number two. Number three, evaluate make or buy decisions. This is not always a popular one because it feels, you know, in some cases, like you're waving the white flag, right? That maybe you shouldn't be making this product, but you should be buying it. And in fact, as one leader told me recently, given the low price of materials on the market from China, we were wondering if we should just build our inventory or slow down our production and ride it out. It being this time period where demand is softer and the pricing is less than ideal. This is a pretty typical approach, actually. I put it in the back to basics category when you think about evaluating make or buy decisions. And we see this a lot in certain markets, right? Certainly olefins and polyolefins, we will see idling of assets. We will see slow rolling of turnarounds or, you know, repairs and restarts. And in many ways, it's really about strategically managing market supply and demand and pricing and profitability, right? It is really an appropriate time when the market is soft. Do you make or do you buy? And understanding what those things are. So those are my three things. When we look at today at market softness, what can you do to create business resilience? Number one, identify your unique value and communicate it and sell it to your ideal customers. Number two, look at diversification and segmentation of your customers and markets and revisit it again. Don't think it's a one and done exercise. It is not. it needs to be done on a regular basis, whether it be half yearly or quarterly, particularly in times when markets are less than ideal. And then the third piece is really evaluate make or buy decisions. You may choose to do business differently today than you would have a year ago. You're making different operating decisions and different manufacturing decisions. And it's valid and it's legit and it's going to help you ride your way through this market softness and build your resilience. So anyway, that's it for today. I'd love to get your feedback on it. And do you have any questions that you want to throw out there to be addressed on one of our Thursday quick hitters? Send me an email, send me a DM on LinkedIn, and we will make that happen. Thanks for listening today. Join us again on The Chemical Show.
We've come to the end of today's podcast. We hope you enjoyed your time with us and want to learn more. Simply visit thechemicalshow.com for additional information and helpful resources. Join us again next time here on The Chemical Show with Victoria Meyer.